to another video game playthrough of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, The Manhattan Project. Now, this is not just another playthrough. This is me playing through the game, so it's not just your average playthrough. You got it? So, let's go to the game. Alright, weekly video content right here. Please like, share, and subscribe. Alright. This game came out kind of under my radar as a kid. I didn't know it was coming out. I don't know why, because I was extremely excited about the first one, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2. But when this one came out, I didn't even know it came out. But when I found out, I was pretty darn excited. There was one kid who lived behind me, and he lived behind me, so we lived behind each other. Our houses were. And he had this game. And his parents were super hip, and my parents weren't as hip as his parents. When I say hip, I mean like in the know of cool stuff that's coming out for preteens. So, you know, I'd go over to his house and we'd play this. And then he'd come over to my house and we'd play the original one, the arcade game. Good old days. Late 90s. That's where life, for me, was the most fun. Lots of childhood friends and family. Yeah, I only played with friends. The grown-ups didn't care for this game when it came out. They were still playing, what do you call it? You know, outdoor games, I think they were called. All the adults were like, hey, let's play some outdoor games. Those are that's what we like, outdoor games. Or indoor games. I know, it was probably all outdoor games. I died. Really? No. I'm not that bad at this game, am I? I guess I am. He's throwing sand on me like I'm a... like I'm a turtle being thrown sand on, trying to escape the beach after being born. So, I've been sick lately. It's brilliant stuff being sick. Feel sick, but you know, I'm an adult, so I have to do adult things alongside being sick, so it's never as exciting as your childhood time being sick. When you're an adult and you're being sick, you kind of still have to do the mundane, which is incredibly exciting stuff down at the core of it all. As you can see, I got a kind of a scratchy voice. Pretty good. You know, went to see Elton John this weekend. He was really great, but the whole time I had a sore throat, and I really needed a nap. And on the way home, I almost puked in the car. So it was great. It was really great. Just kind of wanted to go to sleep the entire time, but again, I was being an adult, and adults just don't, you know, go get a nap whenever they want. So now this activity here, video games. That's special. Alright. Team take this Rocksteady. So. Oh, got him. So, the Cowabunga collection's coming out. No release date yet. It's pretty dismal, if you ask me. Konami not having a release date on the thing. See? I'm sick. It's pretty dismal on the whole getup, if you ask me. Yeah. They have a vague release date of September. I mean, no, summer. So anytime between June, like 20 something, to September 20, late September. So that's when the vague opening of time exists for summer, which is a very wide expanse of time. If you really think about it, there's all those days have mornings, noon, afternoons, and night times. It's pitiful how much time there is. So, you know, the Sonic Origins announcement came out. That has a release date. Pocky and Rocky Reshined. That has a release date. You know, there's multiple games out there right now with release dates. Even games that are people are less excited about. You know, we can go and play most of all these games already if you really, really, really want to play all these games. But it's the convenience of having them all on one collection where you don't have to monotonously you know, dig these games up out of, like, for me to play this, I have to pull the cartridge out and put it in the machine and hope it works. But which will happen someday to the Cowabunga collection in 20, 30 years. They'll be like, oh, this thing called a Nintendo Switch or whatever you want to call it. Let's hope it works. It's got to be, this whole collection's got to be re-released on the new Schmazbug machine. Pretty serious. But we all live in the year 2020, have to wait for the Cowabunga collection on a Nintendo Switch. If I do that, no. Nope. Just gotta keep on doing the old slice jump. There we go, slice jump that guy. Alright. Just a little bit more. Let's fight this boss. I'm not gonna play through the whole game. That'd be crazy. I don't wanna waste your day. You got things to do. Right? You got your own surfing safari to go on. Or sewer surf. That's what I'm talking about. Sewer surfing. All the Ninja Turtle fans out there. Raph. When I was a kid, Raph was my favorite. Because he was moody. And dismal. I was interested in the moody and dismal characters. Leonardo was too optimistic. Michelangelo was too college happy. He was like the guy who would drink beer and crunch his cheeks and spit out a bunch of beer, and you'd be like, no, I don't want that guy at my party, and eat all the pizza. Donatello was too techie nerdy, so I liked Raphael because he was moody. Anyone else can relate to that? He was a moody guy. Didn't have any talent other than fighting real good. He could kick butt. That's what I liked as a kid. Oh, I didn't know that was a feature. Actually, I did know that. I just forgot. Oh, there you go. Save my own butt again. All right. Let's try this one more time. Let's get to the boss. Let's get to the boss. We can do this boss, at least. So, who was your favorite Ninja Turtle as a kid? Yeah, being sick isn't fun. Whoever thought of this stuff? And no, I don't have COVID. I don't. If you think I have COVID, I don't, because I know I took a test. I don't have COVID. COVID free. It's, no. Oh, heck. Oh, heck. All right. Oh, bloody hell. Get me out of here. Get me out of here. Come on. This hole, you gotta beat all the things up before you move on. Rule is a little too serious. Okay. Just want to get to the boss. Get to the boss. We'll be fine. Alright, here we go. Mr. Bull. Mr. Bull, I'm over here. Mr. Bull needs a pipe. Alright. You just run around like a ninny. A ninny head. Whatever that is. Nothing serious here. No serious interpretations of ninny. swing that pipe in the air. So good at that, sir. Alright, I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I'll see you next week with more weekly video content right here. Please like, share, and subscribe.